You know, it's generally known to the public that I'm a guy who can handle his fists pretty good. Tonight on Hippodrome, you're going to watch me fight the Australian light heavyweight champion.
Well, Uncle Jim, I thought you might want to do a little dancing.
No way.
You heard the cue. As a male kangaroo like this, we'll challenge another male for dominance. they've got a couple of tricks up their sleeves. I'll see you. Just relax a second. Hold on. Not prepared.
Wait. Have you had your testosterone checked lately?
Would you just wait a second, please? Amazingly, they can turn their ears 180 degrees each side.
So what happens when you pop him, Brian?
He can listen for a predator on the run, but right now it's all about testosterone. He's going to be challenging me for the young lady that's in the back room. Now, some of you haven't seen her. She's got a baby in her pouch. Casey. The trick that I was about to tell you, when I gear up and get ready to punch him in the snout, hold on, I'm going to punch you right. Let me get one good shot in. Right. Hey. Right.
See how his head goes back? I think we better end this, Brian.
Well, obviously, they don't want to actually punch faces. They just want to show who's tough. Scratch the belly there.
Are you watching how the tail is balancing and is acting like a third leg?
Yeah, they call them the tripod.
Right, and the kangaroo has the most efficient way of traveling. If you have a long tail, you have much more efficiency when you walk around, so it gives you an idea, folks.
Well, 25 feet in each hop and 13 feet straight up from no momentum. All right, now, if he were actually doing this for real, which he is, it was only a show, he would grab his opponent around the waist.
Let's get a round of applause.